Working with people about psychology and nature and doing research on these topics is my professional focus as a psychologist. And it's taken me down many paths, from explaining how to integrate outdoor adventures into counseling, to exploring the psychology of ocean surfing, to documenting the mental health impacts of global climate change. How did I get here? Well, research would show that a childhood spent in the outdoors with adults and mentors who support that child's connection with nature would predict whether someone would be a naturalist or have pro-environmental attitudes or possibly be an environmental psychologist. But it's complicated. I didn't have any of these things growing up. I came from an urban, working-class background that illustrated classic American utilitarian values about nature and other species. My family and I had a sense of moral protection of animals we knew, like our pets, or symbolic animals like horses and bald eagles, but otherwise, a healthy aversion to dangerous aspects of the natural world. But then I've also benefited from the American dream. I've been able to get an education, to travel, and learn a lot. And that has led me to have more aesthetic, scientific, and ecological values about nature, and to feel more confident journeying in the wilderness. In fact, my first job as a counselor was on a wilderness therapy trek that spent weeks on the trail. I've taken people on rafting trips in the Grand Canyon and seen how powerful that experience was. I also spent time working with Greenpeace, and I know how it is to carry the weight of global environmental issues in my daily life. Later, when I began to study clinical and health psychology and worked in hospitals and helped people recover from illness, I began to better understand the healing power of nature I had witnessed, and the complex dilemmas of environmentalists, and how all of this could be understood using psychology.